Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to find the count or frequency of each character present in a string. So I'm going to do this problem in two methods. One is by using just a simple count function if you want like the count of only one letter, or if you want the count of the entire letters present in a string, I will be also doing another method by using a dictionary. Okay, so two methods, you can choose whatever you want. Okay, so let's get started. So first one is a very simple method. We are just going to use a count function. So let sb be some empty string. Okay, hello and how are you, like that, something will be a string. And here we are going to use count function. So count function will return the count of each letter, that is a particular letter we are searching from a string. So c equal to s dot count, and in single quotes that character, I want h. Okay, now so h, and I'll just put print c. Okay, so h is occurring twice, so we need to get the output as 2. So I'm getting the output as 2, that's pretty good, and that's perfect. H is occurring 2, and I will just do R. Okay, so letter R, so R is occurring once, so that's fantastic. And you can also, whether it's like, if you want to find the count of like only one letter from a particular string, you can use this find. Suppose, what if you want like the frequency of all letters present in a string? So for that, we are going to use dictionary. Okay, so dictionary is like has a key and a value. Key is like the control. Yeah, key has, by using the key, we can access the value present in a dictionary. So let's c equal to this curly bracket. Okay, so this represents a empty dictionary in Python. Like if you put c equal to this square brackets, means it represents a empty list. Likewise, c equal to this empty curly braces means dictionary in Python. So what we're going to do is, we're just going to put for I in s. Okay, so this basically corresponds to I, will correspond to the each, and iterate through each character present in our string. Yes, so we're just going to put if I in c. Okay, so this means that we are checking whether the value I is present in c. So at every new iteration, I won't be present in c. Okay, so for that, what I will be able to do is, we will do a else part first. Okay, else c c of I equal to 1. Okay, so this will be like quite confusing. I'll explain it now clearly. So doing the first iteration, okay, our dictionary is empty, so we are checking for I in s to get the each and every letter from our string s. So we are checking if I in s, I in c. So this is because if I is not present in c, means we will put c of I. C of I means that I is the key. Okay, and we are assigning that value as 1 to that ith key present in the dictionary c. This is for the first time when the particular character is coming into the dictionary. So what if I is already present in c? That means that we need to increment our character count, which is already 1, into 2. Suppose if it's already present twice, we need to increment the character count into 3. So for that, what we will do is, we need to put c of I equal to c of I plus 1, the already existing character count into 1. So I will do, I will also show you a live demo. Okay, print c. Okay, so as you can see, we are getting like the character count of each and every letter. H is 2, E is 1, L is 2. That's fantastic. So now I will show you how it works. So during the first iteration, what happens is that, just put comments. Okay, over here, so during the first iteration I in s, h will come. Okay, so if h in c, so h, c is basically empty, so it's not going to, this condition won't be executed. So what will happen here is that inside our dictionary, a key will be created, h, as h, that is c of I, h will be assigned to the value of 1. So this is during the first iteration. Next to next iteration for I in s, our I will be e. So what happens here is that we'll check if E in C. So our C doesn't have, C has only H. So we'll go to else part, and same thing, C of E equal to 1. So it's going to be C of E will be also assigned value as 1. So next is L, same process. It won't go inside it, it will go to the else, and L will also be assigned the value as 1. And next thing is what, that for again another L, we have hello, hell. So two L's. So for L in S, and this time this if block condition will be true because L is already present in C. So what will happen over here is that C of L, okay, C of L equal to C of L plus 1. So our C of L is already, we are having the value as 1. So C of L will be replaced by 1. So which will be equal to 2. And our, at the end of the day, while coming to the next iteration, our L value will be overwritten by 2. That's it. So this is how this entire process will work. So again, O will come. O is not present in C. So we will put O as 1 and blanks. So this is like repeated till we will get the output correctly. And by this method, we can like easily find the frequency or the count of each letter present in a string, and that too in O of n time, that is just by using a single for loop. There is also another way by using two for loops, like, so we'll be requiring O of n square, that is like it will take such a long time to complete. This is like the optimal solution, really good way of finding the frequency of each character present in a string by using an empty dictionary. So I hope you would have got this, found this video useful, and I've also done many tutorials in C, C++, Java, Blender 3D animation, and many more videos in Python. It will be really great if you could go and check my videos and subscribe my channel and support me. Thanks for watching.